Hi guys, this is a video about the face recognition project I have been working on. In this application, I am trying to recognize a face based on the database of faces that we already have. So I'll show you a quick demo of it. So this is the application. The first window shows the camera frames, the second window shows the face detected in the consecutive camera frames, and the third window shows the tracking of the face that was detected. The tracking algorithm works in a way that if the face is detected once in one of the frames, then it's gonna track that particular face even if the face is not detected in the frames. And the biggest window shows the recognition of the face that was detected. We can also train this application to recognize an unknown face on the fly. I'll call one of my colleagues to help me on this. Okay, one of the features of this application is, it's able to track more than one face at a time. So it's like you can track multiple faces with it. Basically, the algorithm works in a way that we create a general model of the face and then we try to fit that model in the face detected. The fitted model is then used to improve the face recognition as well as expression recognition. This is currently a work under progress. Thanks for watching this video.
Hi guys, welcome to a short demo video of my July Hack Day project. We all love tangible interfaces and I've always been keen on doing stuff in this space. As Johan rightly said, interaction with the digital world using physical objects feels so magical. So for this Hack Day, I thought I'll further continue working on the magic. When I came across this concept from touchcode.de, basically, the idea is simple. A set of invisible touch points are printed on the card or an object. When this is placed on the screen, the app reads the pattern and hence the interaction happens. So I've tried to get a version of it running over here. This app is done using Android because the capacitive screen that I'm using is on the tablet that runs Android. The application here is kind of a screen which is placed in a museum. We have tags of various scientists of whom the visitors can get more information by placing them directly on the screen. This of course is just a very simple implementation, but a lot of interesting interactions can be done using this very concept. So the base of these tags has a pattern of touch points which are in this case a set of negative ends of AA batteries. And they get the conduction from my fingers from the top of the tag, which is a layer of aluminum foil. So this was a fun hack day, like all hack days are fun. I enjoyed researching with various capacitive materials, like for example this cellulose sponge, and also some other materials like the negative ends of batteries and also the conductive foam that comes with electronic items, and looking into what works best. Also, I tried to make patterns which work with rotation also, but that was like taking a long time, and these current handmade tags are not that good and they don't always work well. So given the time, we can design better tags, tags which appear as normal objects but still have conduction paths built into them. For example, as it was done with the cars app for the iPad. So that was my hack day for this month. Thanks a lot for watching, and your feedback and comments are always appreciated. Thank you.
This is an integration of the Tobii eye tracking device into Snowflake Suite. This first one is just a demo where it shows like the flames just move around where I look on the screen, as you can see from the webcam. It is just very simple, but it was the first thing I did just to see that it works. And you can also like obviously do what you normally do in Snowflake. You can switch the effects around and it just moves around. This is the Snowflake PDF viewer, but with the added effect of that I can switch pages by looking towards the next page that I want. So if I want the next page now, I just look to the right, and then the next page will just come flowing in, and then I can read this, and once I'm done reading it, I can just look to the right again, and then I get the next page. And this is a pretty nice and easy way to read PDFs. And also, if I want to go back, I can look to the left, and then I get the previous page coming back in. So it's a kind of natural way to read stuff once you get used to it. It just takes some training to train yourself in this, because it's a kind of interface that a lot of people, myself included, aren't very used to. But it's once you used it for a while, it totally makes sense. This could actually pretty easily be added to any Snowflake application now, because we have the tracker library available from doing the tests that we've done so far and the applications that we've done. I think that there are quite a few uses for eye tracking. I think you could do a lot with it if you would want to. I think at this point, it's just the imagination that sets the limits and basically what makes sense. So yeah, if you guys have cool app ideas, it would be fun to see them.
Hi guys, welcome to my first hack day video. In this application, I'm trying to recognize an object based on the information that you already know about it, just like an image of the object. And this is a very crude prototype and the FPS is quite low due to the amount of processing involved. In the coming hack days, I'll try and improve the performance of it as well as use OpenCV to do the tracking stuff. So let's get started. This is the application I've been working on. The first window shows the objects that are to be detected, and the lines show the key points that are matched from the object to the consecutive keyframes. I'll show you a quick demo of it. In this frame, both the objects are detected. Basically, the algorithm works in a way that it's rotation invariant, so even if you rotate the object, it's still gonna be detected. Yeah, so it was a fun hack day and I learned a lot of things about OpenCV, basically how to get the feature points and how to get stuff done with it. So thanks for watching this video.
What I'm going to demo now is a little demo of the Kinect used with Snowflake. It's a pretty basic setup. I have a 46-inch screen, and then above it I have a Kinect tracker. And then I'm going to just do a little bit of PDF browsing and a little bit of looking around the menu. So first I just open the PDF viewer, browse through the menu, find it. And then I just flip through some pages of this PDF, just look around. Then I'm zooming in on a page, and then in the end I just touch the close button. This ended up a little awkward because I chose the close button that was way up in the corner, so it took a while for it to trigger because I'm not that tall. I was standing a little too close, but then I just go back through and then I can see all the apps running again. So yeah, really simple demo, but you can actually use the Kinect with anything in Snowflake because you only have to have a certain depth distance difference. It sounds kind of weird, but it's kind of, it takes a while to figure it out. Basically, it has one depth where it just tracks your hands, and you have one depth where it actually interacts, and it has to do with how much you stick your hands out in front of yourself. I found this to be really flexible, actually. It's not great in every Snowflake application because you need to do some UI adaptations, but overall, it's actually pretty useful and pretty fun to play with the Kinect. It's very interesting device, and I think other 3D tracking stuff will also come up in the future for us, and I think it will be something really interesting to look at.
Category. Animal. Scatter. Dance. Category. Birds. Scatter.
scatter, category, cars, dance, category.